Hello, my people. It's another beautiful Saturday again. Welcome back. I might be Douglas, and in this tutorial, I'll be showing you how I was able to achieve this relationship poster. By the way, if you're new to this channel, do well to hit that subscribe button and turn on the post notification bell so you'll be among the first people to receive an update when a new video drops. And if you also want to see more videos like this, do well to check the description below for the poster design breakdown playlist so you can catch up with the previous videos that I've done. All right, so without wasting much of your time, let's get straight to it. So this poster was inspired by a very creative poster I saw online from a fantastic designer I follow. So this inspiration, this design was made by Nana Multimillionaire, aka Nana Multimedia. So feel free to check him out on Instagram and YouTube. He's a fantastic designer. I've spoke about him in my previous videos. Yeah, so check it out. So you could see some similarities or some things I drew inspiration from. And yeah, so get that. All right, so let's get straight to it. I'm going to break down, I'm going to turn off my layers and then we're going to start. All right, so first thing I did, my background color was white. Okay, and then the next thing I did here was to add this brush. So this brush, right, was something I downloaded online. I just searched for, you could actually use Photoshop to create it, but I just had this in one of my Elements folders. I download Elements and I keep them. So it was something I think I downloaded from Pinterest, I think. Call it brush watercolor effect, something like that. Yeah, so I downloaded it from Pinterest, and then if I open this, this is actually black. It's actually black. Yeah, it's a black brush stroke, and then I added a gradient overlay of two red color shades. Did that and then saved it. So that was what I did. Then the next thing I then added was this text effect. So this text effects, or let's say text effects, this text block. Yeah, so it's just a brief definition of what the theme is all about, which you're going to see soon, or which you've already seen. So just a brief explanation I got from ChatGPT, and then I just, you know, click maxed those text effects in that particular brush. So the next thing I did was to add this heart shape texture, heart shape background. If I disable this, just show you how it is in its normal state. Put it on normal, increase the opacity. So this is how it looks. So I didn't want it to look like this, so that's why I had to use the divide blend mode, and then I reduced my opacity to 39%. And then I also now added this layer mask so I could remove some things here that I didn't want it to be a distraction. And then lastly, I then added this hand. Now this is the disable this, let's disable this. I converted this to black and white, actually, like I always say. I always convert my images to black and white. Put this in normal mode, reduce, open this. So if I remove this, this was power clipped, so I'm going to remove it. I'm going to remove it from here. So this is how the image is, right? Outside, this is how the image is. So converted to black and white, added my blend modes, right? Clip maxed it, and also used my layer marks to brush off this area and all those things. So yeah, that was how I was able to achieve that. So I'm turning back, and then I just grouped everything together and just laid it like this, so it will be easier for me to move it at ease. Okay, so the next thing I did here was another grouping this Sunday, right? This one was just like the body of the text, so you will see the title. No fear. Then I added date and time. So the layers were not like chronologically arranged, right? So I'm just doing this. As I was creating the design, I would just put, and also I didn't like properly arrange the layers, right? So that's why I'm just doing this like from how I placed it when I was doing the design. So it wasn't arranged accordingly. So that's why you'll be seeing, you know, why is this one coming first? Pardon me, or tamper justice witness. All right, so, and then I added this. This is like the address, this date and time and all that. Media handles, social media handles, AOMTV, and then this title. Now, this was how I achieved the title, and this is what I wanted to explain to you guys, right? This is a customized title. I did it with a vector software, CorelDRAW. So this is what I did. Let me take you guys to CorelDRAW. So this is it. This is my CorelDRAW workspace. The font I used for this is Beaming. You could download it on thatfont.com, or you could just search it on Google, right? Beaming. So I downloaded this and then I wrote this, right? What I now did was to just break my text apart. For CorelDRAW users, if you want to break your text apart, you click on Ctrl K. Sorry guys, let me turn on my QAZ. If you want to break a text apart on CorelDRAW, you just click on Ctrl K and it breaks your text apart. And so I then replaced this O with a doodle shaped, a doodle heart shape. Just replaced it. Yeah, because it's a relationship designed for young people. So I wanted to grab their attention soul to soul, and that's why you could see how I was able to, first and foremost, I replaced the O's with the doodle heart shape, so it signifies love. And then the big S, since there was no point using two S's for soul and soul, so I just had to use one to cover up for both of them. It's a much, much way, more better way to represent that. And then, you know, the S also carries, you know, this kind of heart shape. So when you see this kind of title, right, it basically tells you that it's a relationship stuff. So that was the goal. That was what I wanted to achieve, and I was able to achieve that. Kudos to the creator of this phone. All right, so I was able to do that, and when I finished, I exported my file as an SVG. So this is for those who are using CorelDRAW and they want to export a customized text to Photoshop. If you want to do that, right, export as SVG. So I click on Ctrl E, and in this option here, I'm just going to go to my downloads, and this option where you see save as, you select SVG. Sorry, where is it? SVG, yeah. Scalable vector graphics. The reason why you are exporting as SVG, so it can be easy for you to edit on your Photoshop, right? It's easy to edit SVGs both on your Photoshop and also on your vector-based software, whether it's CorelDRAW or Illustrator. So that's why I exported as SVG. It will come up here and show up some things. You don't need to make any change here. And you just click on OK. Go to your desktop here. This is where my, okay, go to downloads actually, so. And then you just drag and you drop it here. Yeah, so this is it. Okay, bring it here. Where is that layer? Okay, yeah, this is the layer. So just take it up a bit. Let me just take it out so you could see it. So this is it. So just brought it here, very simple. Double click. It's already, once you drag it, it's already automatically a, what do they call it? A smart object. So what I just did was to just change the color to white, and doing that was just to go to my blending options. I go to blending options here and I go to color overlay. So in this color overlay, just change it to white here, and my preview section is on, so you see. So that was how I was able to achieve that. Okay, and then I now added my text here. By the way, the font that I used for everything here is Nexa. It's a font family, very amazing font family. So I added this, the subheading, or yeah, the subheading that aligns off, that follows the theme or the heading in quotes, a relationship talk. So I just added it there and then grouped everything together to form my title. So that was how I was able to achieve that. So just added Papa's picture as my pastor's picture, and then I added his name. Same font, everything I used here was Nexa. I didn't use any other, so it's Nexa family. That's what I used. Added this and all that just to create a good color contrast. So I did that, and then the next thing I did was to add the logo. Added the church logos, the youth church logo as well. And then I also thought of making this design a bit more interesting. Like I said, the target audience is for young people, youths between the ages of 20 to 40. Right, so I was like, okay, I know I have passed the message, but I wanted to still make my background a little bit interesting. You know, you could see some spaces and all that. This is actually good, but like, okay, I could do some things to make it more interesting. So I added some hard doodles, right? So like that, this hard doodle that I used on my Corel Draw, I exported it as an SVG too, and just came here, brought it here, added a gradient overlay effect, and that was still from the blending options. So this was where I added it, gradient overlay. I just added, picked the colors from the design, actually two red colors I was using, added that, and then I just placed them in strategically, actually in different places to occupy some, just to fill up some spaces and all that. Sorry, I just added it in some positions there. Yeah. And then I added this pattern, you know, to also fill it. This pattern too, it is white. And let me bring it out actually so you guys could see. So this is a pattern. Yeah. This is a pattern. So it's white. And so I just changed or added like a gradient overlay over it, still using the same color. The reason why these things were done was also to make the design uniform, right? So me using a different color entirely, it will just make this design off, to just put it off. So because the color palette on this design basically is red, two shades of red and white, and then black can also complement when tons of some emphasis and all that. So that was why I did that. And then as I finished, converted everything to one layer, which is like a general tool, always shown it in my previous videos, your shift control alternate E. It gives you one, converts or merges all your layer into one layer, one image, as the case may be. And then you convert this to a smart object, right? It's a smart object, and then you go to your camera raw and you finish work. Yeah, go to your camera and you finish work. So you just shift control A, go to your camera raw. That's a general shortcut. And then on your camera raw, go now play with it however it is you want, but don't go overboard. So added my grains. I always add grains to my design. It's like a noise effect, so you could see it. Don't make it too, depend on what you want to do, Sha. It's personal preference, right? I'm not saying it must be the way I did it. So depending on what you want to do. So I just make it a little bit subtle, not too much and all. And then I just make one or two adjustments in the clarity and the texture section. Yeah, so that's just what I did. Played around with this guy. I'm going to click yes. I'm not going to apply this effect because I've already done that. And then voila. This is the design. So I'm sure you guys might be, this tutorial is short today. Yeah, actually it's a very short one, but a very simple, straightforward, but very creative relationship design. And so that's a way to achieve that. Yeah, here you go. All right, so we have come to the end of the class. Do let me know what you think about this breakdown session in the comments below. Do not also forget to like and also share this video to a designer today. And like I said, if you are yet to subscribe, if you're new and you're yet to subscribe, go ahead to hit that subscribe button and turn on the post notification bell for future videos. Don't also forget to check on the poster design breakdown playlist, link in the description and also showing on your screen somewhere, either by the left or the right, so you could catch up with the previous videos that I've done. And if you also have some tutorial requests you would want me to do videos on, also do well to fill in the Google form with that link. All right. Okay, guys, thank you so much for your time once again, and I'll see you guys next Saturday. Peace.